Hi everyone, I'm Shauna and welcome to the channel. Today's video is an anti-haul, or okay, it's more of like a will I buy it, but I'm gonna do my best to anti-haul most things that we're gonna be talking about today. The holiday releases have hit hard, both Halloween, which are much fewer, but also like true holiday, you know, Christmas, snowflakes, snowmen, peppermints, candy cane, you know, Too Faced, usual holiday in some kind of city, same palette since 2013 kind of releases. You know what I'm talking about, the gift sets, the shitty quality makeup releases. In this video, you will not hear me say, well, you can break it up and give it to your friends as separate gifts. No. So I'm feeling a little roasty, a little sassy, so I'm ready to start talking through these releases and hopefully talk you out of buying new makeup. Elephant in the room, I cut my hair. It hasn't even been 24 hours yet. If you don't like it, you don't need to share your thoughts here. Now let's get into it, my friends. The first thing I want to talk about is the new Hocus Pocus collection from ColourPop. So I'll move over a little bit so we can like have lots of room here. I admittedly have never seen Hocus Pocus. I was in the generation where that came out. So it's not like I was too young or too old for it. There's some movies that I just, like I've also not seen Practical Magic, and I didn't even know that was a movie until this year. I think this might be the year that I watch it. So I guess I can say that I'm not somebody who sees it and just goes gaga over it because of intellectual property. I personally, like this doesn't do anything for me as a collection. There's the purples and like the turquoise colors that I just would never wear. But I guess some of it, when it comes to intellectual property collabs, usually but not always, the makeup brand tries to include colors that seem fitting to that brand that they're collaborating with. So I don't know if there's purples and turquoises that are really evident in the movie. I don't know how well this matches with the movie, but as a color story, when I look at it, I don't totally know what I would even do with it. I wouldn't use the purples and the turquoises. So that's already a good third of the palette that I wouldn't use. But I find it hard when there's colors, like there's two strong colorways in here, and then there is like that red pairing, and then I don't know, there's like a brown and a green. It kind of seems like there's four pairings of two. And we've seen this a lot with ColourPop. They've done it with the Lizzie McGuire palette. They've done it with the Powerpuff Girl palette. I'm sure there's more. To me, that's like now becoming a signature of ColourPop, and it's not particularly unique anymore. But I find some of these colors hard to mix, or at least this is not a particularly mixable palette, in my opinion. But then if you have the turquoise as an example, what would you pair with it? Maybe that's just a me problem, like I don't have a good understanding of color theory. I just would find it hard to create looks with this. I think that's all I'm trying to say. Then there are the lip products. There's a purple and then a black. They're too bold for my liking, so I wouldn't wear them. And to me, when it comes to this, like there's certainly people out there who would wear a really super dark, bold black or super dark purple lip. That could be you. But what I find with these things is that you might be drawn to that color right now, or because it's Halloween time, even if the packaging isn't Halloween themed. There are certain times of the year when we can get drawn into very specific color stories, or it's our color story right now. Like what happens in 2 years when you used it once, when you bought it in fall 2021 because you were loving purples, and then what? Like you bought it to wear twice. Last thing I'm going to say about this are the eyeshadows. I just don't find this particular color story all that inspiring. I don't really find it particularly Halloween or spooky or grungy. And if you watched my last like fall makeup video, you would know that I'm into these grungy tones. This just doesn't feel all that inspiring to me. I don't want to grab it and just like sink my teeth into it. The last thing I'm gonna say about this ColourPop release is that this just doesn't feel inspired to me. Okay, I'm gonna make a comparison here. I recently watched the Lula Rich documentary, and there was a designer in there who was like designing the leggings, and she was saying that they were basically responsible for turning out 100 patterns a day or something like that, and that they turned out so many patterns that they were just struggling to come up with anything remotely new, that the quality of the design suffered. I don't think it's all that surprising. That's kind of what I feel about ColourPop. It's like they've done so much, and they've put out so many releases. Even if you just look at 2 years worth of content from them, 2 years worth of product, there's so much. And it just feels like there's design fatigue at ColourPop. Somebody also made the comment that this looks like the Persona Identity palette. I think it's the Identity 2 palette. I kind of agree. It does look really similar. What I think is going to entice a lot of people is the Hocus Pocus packaging. If it wasn't that, I just think that a lot of people would really see the color story for what it is. It's just not special. Let's talk about the Sephora sets. In the past, I've been a sucker for a Sephora set, and I've bought some before. Now, I think it's always timely to say that if we're talking about something like one category of makeup or product, like hair or lips or eyeshadow, we can get overwhelmed really easily by bringing in too much in one category. If you get the lip set or one of the lip sets, you're bringing in so many new products at once, like, are you gonna get to them? And then what if you buy, let's say, another kit somewhere else? The holidays is a time where we really fall into this value for money kind of rhetoric, or we're so enticed by the value for money, and that we buy a lot of stuff in terms of quantity. Maybe it's even for a great price, but then how long is it actually gonna take for you to just try the products that you bought? Maybe you get to them really quickly, but if you're somebody like me where you're a bit kind of like slow to act, if I bought 5 Nula products all at once, I at most would swatch them in one day. I wouldn't wear them all on the same day, or if you want to actually wear them, at most you could only get to them really in like 5 days. But do you? And so I get overwhelmed when I get inundated with too much newness all at once, especially in one product category. And then at that point, it almost feels like I bought just for the rush of the quantity, and then stuff just sits around. So I think it could be important to ask yourself, are you buying it because it's a good deal, because you're getting a lot for a good price? Or will you use everything? Will do all the colors in for all of the products speak to you and work for you and your skin tone? I stopped buying kits for that exact reason, is because there's always something that just doesn't work for my skin tone or my preferences, and that's always a deciding factor. I have a hard time justifying, oh, well, there's 6 products in here and 5 work and 1 doesn't, so it's good for the money. I need every product to work. Otherwise, I personally feel wasteful. Unless like all 5 for 5 or all 6 for 6 work for me, I wouldn't buy it. Now, the Sparkly Clean set has a new Tower 28 product. I thought it already existed, and maybe it was only on the Tower 28 website, but I went searching for it, and I saw the actual color of the product. And initially, my first reaction to this was, oh, Tower 28 has a new lip product. I need it because it's Tower 28. I like the brand. And I initially didn't like the swatch, but I'm like, no, it's okay. Like, I know you'll like it. It's Tower 28. Just because your favorite brand releases something new doesn't mean you have to own that thing, even if it's cheap. And once I took a step back, I do think the Tower 28 lip product is probably really nice, but it's just not in a colorway that I would wear. And Sephora did something really smart by putting in this makeup product that isn't going to be released individually until after this kit is released. So in order to try this product first, you have to buy the kit. And there's a lot of people who want to buy the kit just for the new Tower 28 product. Okay, listen, I'm going to be your voice of reason for a second. If the only reason you're buying this kit is for the Tower 28 lip product, don't. Because the product will release on its own in a couple of months. You can wait. And if the whole point of getting is this set, we're basically saying that we're so impatient that we can't wait. We need this now. We need this now. And I'm not sure if I'm describing this feeling as I would like, but I was a little taken aback that I was willing to kind of put everything aside, my best judgment or how I feel about all the other products, just to try this one thing first. Am I so impatient that I simply cannot wait 2 months? No makeup is ever that important to me, or at least I don't think that it should. Where I would spend, this is probably, I think it's $38 USD, which means it's probably more like $48, $50 Canadian. So is this $18 lip product worth $50 essentially? No. The Sparkly Clean Kit is somewhat enticing. There's a full-size Merit blush in there. I'm pretty sure it's the exact same color that I have, so I wouldn't buy it. And then I really wanted to try Say Beauty, but that line is just not meant for my skin tone. I think I included it in a Brands I Want to Try in 2021 video because I was so enticed by the aesthetic of that brand, but that brand just isn't meant for my skin type. So really, that's just half the box right there. So that one is just like a pass for me. And then for the other like lippy set, it has Cruella, the NARS lip pencil in there. I've already owned it. And I'm not super into mattes these days, and I already have a red lip that I really like. Cruella is a long-standing staple in the NARS lip range, so it's a good chance that you already have it somewhere. That's the other thing about holiday sets, is that often we're willing to have duplicates in order to get other things in a set. If you already own Cruella, you don't need to to own it again. If you just want that Summer Fridays lip product, just go buy it. Wait for that Sephora sale, get your 15 or 20% off, and like call it a day. I'm particularly drawn to YSL right now. I'm not really sure why, so I am kind of interested in that product, but I've already had Cruella. I don't really wear mattes. Are you wearing mattes right now? Everything else in here is like creamy or balmy except for the NARS matte product. So are you wearing matte lips these days? If not, that could just be a waste of money. Next up is the Forbidden Fruitcake palette by Too Faced. Too Faced is a brand that, in my opinion, is incapable of producing anything that's like ironically funny. Even if they are trying to be ironically funny, because it's Too Faced, I will never take it as that. This palette honestly seems like a joke, and a joke in the sense of are you kidding me, Too Faced? Maybe Too Faced meant for this to be a joke, like haha, like everybody loves fruitcake, like wink wink, because nobody loves fruitcake. But because it's Too Faced, it feels way more like they just missed the mark. To me, this is so dumb. The packaging on this is stupid. First of all, I really think fruitcake's an American thing. I don't really see fruitcake here. I mean, I live in Canada, like we're not culturally that different. I've never had fruitcake. I don't know anybody who eats fruitcake. I never really see it in the grocery store. It's not this like iconic cultural symbol here, at least that's how I feel. Why would you want a fruitcake palette? I'm almost lost for words. Then we get to the color story. You cover up that blue color. It's just so uninspiring. Too Faced, a holiday is, if I'm gonna avoid a brand, it's gonna be Too Faced. Okay, so this particular page is like a whole bunch of releases all in one. I was on Sephora's website this morning, and actually a lot of these are already available to see. Tarte has the blush set is already online, the different Tarte mascaras, the Pat McGrath lip sets are already online, the Laneige stuff is all online. Last year I saw that Laneige had those lippy products, like their balmy tubes, I don't know what they're called. I own one, I don't know what it's called. They had a set of three last year, and I bought one around holiday time, but didn't really test it out until later on. So I missed the three pack, and I have been looking for it, That to me is one of the best lip balms I've ever tried. I do like the Glossier lip balm. I've talked about that in the past, but I don't like to wear that out in the world right now because I don't want to take my finger and apply it to my lips. And the Laneige lip balm has been such a staple and the thing I carry around in my purse, or if I'm going out like anywhere, going for a bike ride, going to the gym, going to the grocery store, that's just in the purse because no matter what I'm wearing, if I have makeup or not, it'll just go. So I was really looking forward to that bigger pack because I would totally buy it during the Sephora sale, get the discount, and then I'm covered for lip balms for a year. That's what I wanted to do. I don't see it here. So I hope that what I'm about to say isn't hypocritical since I wanted to buy like a bulk pack, but some of these Laneige sets with 3 and 5 of their lip sleeping masks, that feels different because I've used a lip sleeping mask from Laneige. It takes me about a year to get through them. Do you need 3? Like, how long is that gonna actually take you to use? I feel like the selling point here is look at these flavors and then you're gonna go in and you're gonna try them, and the whole point is just to try new flavors. I can't justify that, and it just kind of feels like a waste of my money just to try new flavors. Do you really need to bring in 3 all at once? Do you need 3 years of Laneige lip products right now? My answer is no, and I'm hoping to be a voice of reason here. The Tarte blush set, I saw swatches of it, and I'm particularly in a butt blush moment, like I'm looking out in the world for blushes. It did not dawn on me until this year how crazy some of these bulk pack releases have been. Every year for a while, Tarte has released these blush sets, either in just in different formulas or different formats. Sometimes in that like book, and then you have all these blushes, like a face palette. They also had, I don't know if it was last year or the year before, it was almost like those melt stacks, but they had them for blushes and maybe it was bronzer and highlight. I don't remember exactly what that looked like. But every year they release these big blush releases. And as somebody who has actively tried to pan blush, it takes forever. Nobody needs 5 blushes to be brought in at one time. It will take you so long to get through them, which means that if you are buying these for yourself, you are likely buying them to never finish them. If you have, let's say, 5 other blushes in your collection already, even if you have just one other blush in your collection, you have many years worth of blush here. At least 5, and those are minis, at least 5 years worth of blush here. That to me is ridiculous. And I used to think, wow, this is such a great deal. And I actively looked for these Tarte blush kits because I could have different varieties, or I could have them all in one if it's a palette. But my mindset on this has really changed. It's too much all at once. And it's like, just, it's overwhelming. It's overwhelming. And I think for a lot of us, we're better able to handle a lot of things coming in at once for some categories better than others. I think a lot of us are better at handling lip products, even though I just talked about that before. To have 5 blushes to me just feels so unmanageable to come in all at once. As I said, and I think the point is worth reiterating, all you need to do is buy 2 sets. And then you have like 10, 12, 15 products. Like, it's just, it's the time of year that is promoting excess through the sale of the sets, and they become quite irresistible because of how great the prices are. Don't get sucked in by the price. Don't get sucked in for the value for money, because we are living in a moment of value for money culture, of fast and like more is more. I personally feel like I need to keep that in mind because some of my worst spending has happened at the holidays. Last year I was on a no buy, so that never really happened. So I feel like I need to be cognizant of not getting sucked in to the value for money and to the more is more kind of buy all the gift sets. Somebody who's kind of just falling into that is the Charlotte Tilbury gift set. She has this box. It's like 200 and how much? It's 260 euros for her advent calendar. This has to be like $350. Makeup just shouldn't cost that much. period. And this is a pure more is more kind of thing. And there's a lot of collections out there like Charlotte Tilbury, but also Too Faced, Pat McGrath that are, or even Hourglass, we'll talk about them, that are known for that palette release at the holiday time. Don't get sucked into collecting. You don't need to buy the new Charlotte Tilbury holiday palette because you bought one the last 2 years in a row. Now, let's now talk about the Hourglass palette, or the Hourglass palettes. I bought one 2 years ago. It was something like $110 Canadian for the palette. And I've spent the last year essentially trying to pan it. I've hit pan on a couple of things, but likely won't finish any of the products this year. I mean, I can't say for sure not. There's a good amount of product in that palette, but there's basically nothing Hourglass could produce at that price that I would say is worth the money. Hourglass is a brand that is similar to me in a lot of ways, like Physicians Formula, who have repeatedly refused to listen to their customers. The Hourglass, people have been screaming at Hourglass to be more inclusive, to release palettes that are suitable for more than just white people. And they released two this year. And I was reading the Trend Mood comments, and there's people who are in the comments who are saying too little too late, but also that they don't trust this release because the photo that is available is on a model. And people also are skeptical about this because last year I think it was one of their limited edition blushes, or they released a blush shade and then they made it look darker than it actually was and more suitable for deeper skin tones than it actually was. So there's a lot of disbelief that the palette is not going to be suitable like the pictures might make it seem to be. And for a lot of people, it just seems too little too late. One release is not a good judgment of whether they're actually listening. That is, one release could just be tokenistic or pandering. And so it's gonna be what does it look like for the next year for them? And my gut is telling me that this feels more like a one-off than a new direction for Hourglass or a brand that is listening. I don't know, maybe these things are more separate in your minds than in mine, but their new release with that palette that was like $200, you all know the palette that I'm talking about. If you think that's okay, it kind of says a lot about your brand. There's a line, even for a high-end brand, where it goes into the absurd, or literally trying to take your customers for all the money that they have. And that's what that release felt like. NARS released some of their holiday sets as well. NARS, somebody at NARS, like, who does their swatching or their photographing of their new releases, whoever's job that is at NARS, they should be fired, because their swatches and their like actual product photos routinely look horrible and fake and make all the products look way less appealing than they actually are. NARS is also a brand that's pretty expensive, and I don't own a lot from NARS for that reason. Their eyeshadow palette, cool color story, just not something that I would want to wear every day. There's that hot pink shadow and then that like glittery pink or that sparkly pink that's like in a deeper shade, not something I would wear every day. I don't know, the color story just does not seem cohesive, and it seems kind of like, it does seem bold. You have two transition shades or two like crease shades and then one outer crease shade, which is a red. That's such a bold look. It doesn't give me anything to really work with other than this bright red outer corner look, like no thanks. And then their face palette, it's not meant for me. And I actually feel like, I mean, it really depends on how the swatches go. I haven't seen them yet. It really feels like they're that bigger face palette. It honestly seems like it's for a deeper skin tone, which is not something that we see all the time. But there's no swatches to really confirm this, so like at the end of the day, I'm not sure. Overall though, it just seems like kind of a weird choice for a holiday collection. And I think because of the kinds of products NARS has released in the past and the kinds of shades that they've chosen, I think a lot of people just overlook NARS when it comes to holiday collections. Now, I'll briefly touch on the Pat McGrath collection, although I don't have a lot to say, because Pat McGrath is just, as a whole, out of my price range. So there have been some things that I've wanted to try from them in the past. There's one eyeshadow palette that's been on my radar for a little bit. It's one of their quads, but their quad is like $78. So I'm just not really checking for Pat McGrath because my assumption is always like, I can't afford this. But the eyeshadow palette, one of the things I've heard from people is that this is like a great value for money because her palettes are usually like 12 shades for like what, $150 or like $170 Canadian. And so this palette is a way better deal than that because it's $78 USD, which is probably around $100 Canadian. One of the things about Pat McGrath that I think inspires a lot of people is that her color stories are so unique. And if you've been on this channel, you know that I'm not a very colorful kind of gal when it comes to my makeup. I'm really neutral and really neutral, almost like basic when it comes to my eyeshadows. So I typically find her color stories overwhelming and confusing, maybe even a little chaotic. So I just don't think that this is a brand that's meant for me. But what I do know is that a lot of us at holiday time, if there's a brand we can't afford and they got a kit or they got a set or they have like a special deal, that's like a way in to trying that more expensive brand that we can't afford. And if that's you, sure. Like if you love this color story, sure. Because a brand that might be typically out of your price range is now in, like I can get that. But my butt here is that if the only reason you want to buy this palette is because of the price, is because this expensive brand is now in your price range, therefore I should try it, that I'm not a fan of, because it's just putting price first over everything else. One of the last things that we're going to talk about is the new MAC collection. It is their Tempting Fae collection, and I believe it's out now. And the packaging on this is really beautiful, but to me, MAC, when it comes to their holiday, not their holiday, when it comes to their special collections, which they do release very often throughout the year, it's not just at a holiday time, they are so hit and miss in terms of packaging, branding, ideas, but also like colors and like the overall quality of the products too. I find MAC, like these bigger collections opposed to their staple products, so hit and miss that if a brand is so inconsistent, almost in the way that Too Faced is, I have no trust in their ability to produce a collection. But more so than that, if you are so hit and miss, like why can't we be consistent? If we take packaging out of here, I don't trust a brand that's so inconsistent. Like, would you trust, if you're dating somebody, would you trust that person if they're so inconsistent? If their pendulum is constantly swinging? I guess makeup is not people, okay. But I can't trust you, MAC. Their eyeshadow palette is particularly interesting, and it's one that I feel like I just get sucked in because of the color story. But if you look at the palette online, like on the Trend Mood post, it looks different in every picture. I don't actually know what this looks like. And it does look like it's mostly like a shimmer palette. And listen, you know, I love a shimmer. I really do. But it has to be, there still has to be mattes to ground a look. Or if it's an all shimmer palette, it has to be the right kinds of tones and the right kinds of depth. So despite this looking like an almost all shimmer palette, it's just not the right colors for me, and I think I would have preferred some of these colors if they were matte. But this really screams fall, and I'm just looking at it like, damn, you're beautiful. Okay, that's the video. It was definitely not as like hot take, hot fire as I initially expected. I was trying to be more reasonable and like, let's think about this beyond the individual product or the color story. But I would love to know your thoughts on some of the products I mentioned here today. I often have diverging opinions from some of you, which I actually love to hear your takes too, because y'all often make me think twice as well. And I always think it's just nice to get to hear other opinions, especially y'all in this community. So let me know your thoughts down below in the comments, and thank you so much for watching. I hope to see you again around here soon. Bye.